Good morning, y'all. So today I want to do more of a vlog style video for multiple updates going on with me. We will do a little bit of a skincare update, a life update, mental update, debt update, all of those things. I thought this would be a good way to update the masses and give you guys something visual to reference, at least seasonally, so like four times a year. So we will be doing a little bit of chatting today, but first things first, I'm actually getting a facial and I'm taking you guys along with me. That usually
you're
a good
so
angle.
Yeah, you always look so good.
Are you kidding, girl? I didn't wash my, you know, I don't wash my face before I come here because I just wake up and I'm like,
I'm gonna
okay.
Do it anyway.
Yeah, I'm like, we'll end up triple cleansing within an hour, right? So but I'm gonna leave a lot more glowy than this, I can guarantee you. I got some blackhead situations, but they're minor. It's nothing bad. Excited to get them to evacuate thy face. Hello, glow.
Hello, glow.
Whole different person. A lot cleaner. You saw the extractions. We're all set. Let's go home. So before I start folding some laundry, I wanted to show you guys a few things I got from Yes Style. More importantly, not the most traditional things. That guy over there, he got some feelings about it. Is this not a great purchase?
It is not a great purchase.
Are you serious? Are you serious? Before I show you guys this amazing toothpaste holder that actually comes with a toothbrush holder that we don't need, I also got a pore suction vacuum, which makes a interesting noise. You didn't see it out of the packaging yet, but this is an ear pick.
Okay.
And you put batteries in the bottom.
Batteries?
Yeah, because this lights up so you can see what you're doing.
In your ear.
I got this for you. Because Chris has drier earwax than me. I have wet earwax. TMI, who cares? Earwax is earwax. It comes with two pieces and it actually comes with tweezers, but don't really support the tweezers. And I know you're not technically supposed to get anything out of your ears, but in certain situations, advised by doctors, sometimes you have to put stuff like, what is it, like a liquid in your ear, and then sometimes it doesn't all come out. So I need to see. It was a loving gesture, dear. You don't seem like you love it at all. Not like I'm using it yet and doesn't have any batteries, but these are just interesting Yes Style purchases on my behalf. But because Yes Style allows me to try some different things when I'm curious, I was like, why not? But now I'm gonna show you guys the toothbrush holder. Keep saying brush. It's a paste. Look at the genius.
Look at this mess.
Go ahead. You did that.
I put it in and took it back out.
Oh my goodness. It's just a little bit. You get a little bit. Oh, now it's not working. You broke it! Oh, see, you just get a little bit. I don't know what you did.
Yeah.
It worked this morning.
Look at all that mess in there.
I did that because you did that.
I put it in.
It worked perfectly this morning. Look what you did.
Yeah, okay, one out of five times.
Okay, I used it last night too. Two out of two.
One out of five times works every time.
Okay, Chris has obviously messed with it in preparation. But it has like a little silicone tip that opens when you push this. Otherwise, it keeps it sealed so your toothpaste doesn't dry out. And now we have to brush our teeth. This is what happens when it messes up. You have to brush your teeth. Remember, I have my hair. Loving you. Look away, everybody.
Dentists love it. It forces you to brush your teeth extra.
Hey, it worked. This morning, perfectly.
Yeah.
I even made an Instagram story of it. There's proof. There's proof. I'm putting the Instagram story on this video. Right here. It's working. It is working.
perfectly.
Just when you're here, it doesn't like doubters.
Yeah, every time.
You may also be wondering what the heck I'm holding. So I have a stabilizer on my camera. It has a little baby tripod, little feets at the end. Excuse the fact that I have a recording light in here. I have it just lighting up this side of the room because typically I keep my room pretty dark because you're supposed to sleep here, and I only have that lamp, no overhead. So if I'm vlogging, I have to bring in one of my studio lights and just kind of point to the ceiling like it's a lamp. This is the crane I'm using. It comes with the little tripod feet. It's good for point and shoots and phones. They have bigger cranes for DSLRs and heavier mirrorless cameras. I got this one just because I wanted it for this specific Canon that I'm using. There's a Sony, it's my previous vlog camera shown on this. It works for those too. Also works for GoPro. I got this because I've always wanted a stabilizer, and I had a few things I wanted, including this video, to be a little bit more stable because I realized my arms just getting shakier throughout my life. And it was $70 off on Amazon compared to like Best Buy in their actual website, so I got it. I also wanted to give you guys a little skin update after my facial. And I know people have questions if I'm still on spironolactone, so hopefully she is. I am. I'm currently still on the same amount of spironolactone. A lot of people have been asking me, just because a lot of you have started spiro yourself. It's spironolactone. Excuse my pronunciation all the time. There hasn't been really any huge change as far as my original video goes. I still think it is controlling my cystic hormonal acne very, very well. I rarely have a cystic breakout. The only time I might have even a minor, like 5% of what it used to be, breakout is if I forget a day in some reason. I do keep my pills in my nightstand. I just take it before bed. Spiro does not keep you from getting whiteheads and blackheads. Like, it only prevents hormonal cystic acne. I'm still having a really good experience with it, and I don't see a reason to get off of it at this time. Would I want to be on it for the rest of my life? Ideally not. This did not feel like something that I could dedicate another full video to, so that's why I just wanted a little skincare update section. So I'm going to finish up the laundry, and then it's gonna be dinner time, so let's jump into that. Good morning. So it's the next day. We had more of a gloomy, rainy day yesterday, so I thought I'd pick up the video this morning. Right now it's early in the morning. I'm trying to get to a workout class, and I want to sit and chat with y'all. I also need to get ready. As you can see, I'm in this amazing attire, slippers and all. But I would like to get some food going. So yesterday we were cooking a meal from Green Chef. So I wanted to make the meal that we made last night for date night again, because I really, really like it. And we have two additional servings. Time, had a couple meetings today, took a couple conference calls, and waited for a package to be delivered, which was by Green Chef, who is the sponsor of today's video and the first sponsor of 2020 and supporter of this channel. As you can see, Christopher has joined me today, and Tuesday is
Sam day.
It's date night. He's still getting it wrong. He thinks it's funny. Originally, when we started dating, Tuesday was the designated day that we would hang out, thus being Sam day. But when we got married, I said it's now date night. I'm sure you're wondering, what is Green Chef? What are the details? I will let you guys know and see while I prep the ingredients. Green Chef is a USDA certified company that makes eating well easy and affordable with a variety of different dietary meal plans. The recipes are quick and easy. They have step-by-step instructions, chef tips, and the best part to me, photos, because I mean, who doesn't love photos? You really can't go wrong. Anyone can do this. Chris cooked the meal yesterday all by himself. It came out wonderfully. And usually he has to ask me, like, what does this mean? How do I cut this? Like, am I doing this right? But he just did it, and it was quick. Everything is handpicked and delivered right to your door. Green Chef is actually owned by HelloFresh. So between the two brands, they offer a variety of different diets. Some of you may remember I have worked with HelloFresh on my channel in the past. And between Green Chef and HelloFresh, they do have such a huge variety of meal plans. So there's something for everyone. You can definitely find something that's fitting your lifestyle, your needs, or maybe something you wanted to try. Green Chef has 5 different meal plans. So they have paleo, plant-powered, vegan and vegetarian, keto, balanced living, and family. And there's descriptions on the website. We are on the balanced living plan. It is a nice way to eat something a little fresher, a little healthier, and sneak in some vegetables into Chris's diet. The ingredients inside of the box come pre-measured, perfectly portioned, and mostly prepped. So it speeds up the process and also has less waste. Save space in your fridge too, guys. This is all I need
for an entire meal, 2 servings. Green Chef was nice enough to provide 4 servings of every meal, and I'm gonna bring a serving of each meal type to my mother-in-law after my workout class. Servings start out at just $5, and depending on the plan you pick, it can go up $1 or $2 for each serving, which I find very, very affordable, very budget friendly. So if you guys are interested in trying Green Chef for yourself, they are offering my viewers $80 off and free shipping from your first order. So all you have to do is go to greenchef.us/sam80. It'll be on the screen right here and at the top of my info box. So go click it and hit get started to try them for yourself.
I haven't got to break in my new pan. This is the Aisha Curry White Marble Collection. I believe it was with Home Shopping Network, or Keepsie, or one of those. And I got this for Christmas for my sister, and I haven't really had a reason to break it out. I've just been using my old pots and pans, and I've been saving these for when we move. But since this one is kind of individual, I was like, "Hey, baby, we'll use you today." She's so pretty, and I'm still babying her. Like, it has her signature and everything on it. Everything else is like in the dishwasher, it's clean, it's ready. That's the best part about cleaning while you're still cooking, and the fact that the majority of the meal was in the oven, I could still clean, and I don't got a huge mess afterwards. Hello! Actually made by my people, and yes, I have a not trash thing for the cleaning crew whenever they come, you know, the months they do. But these have the rest of the pots, which I'm gonna break out at the next house. I figured I shouldn't unbox it because we're gonna have to move them.
As you can tell by my not so curly hair, all sweated out, and outfit change. I've already finished my workout class, which I'll show you guys in a second. I ate one of the pepper servings prior to going just for that, you know, energy boost, but I'm really gonna sit down and enjoy my food right now because I'm hungry. You know how hungry you get after workout class? Finishing up my workout water, which is about 40 ounces. I like to finish this before like moving on to any other drinks of the day because you guys know I like my soda too. So since you guys got a little bit of a skin update earlier, I figured we could sit down, chat, and have a little like mukbang type of situation without too much of the chewing. To the gigantic pepper. And kind of just chat more about a life update. I know this video isn't for everyone who is subscribed to this channel because not everyone's like invested in me personally, which is totally fine. But for those who are and are still watching, thank you so much. I appreciate you guys. As a lot of my second channel viewers know, we are moving in less than like, basically it's 90 days. It's like 92 days right now. We rent this house. Our landlord for almost 4 years is selling it now. They don't even live anywhere near us. So they're just, you know, just done being landlords for no other reason, but they're very, very nice. And that means we have to figure out where we're living. So that's what we've been doing. Basically every Friday we've been touring houses, and we don't know if we're really gonna be buying or not, or if we're gonna be renting. It just really depends if the stars align. And I keep using that saying because Northern Virginia has a very aggressive housing market. And those who live in like New York, San Fran, LA, you guys can understand. You guys are the few cities, in my opinion, that are way worse. DC is definitely top 5. And Nova, Northern Virginia, is surrounding DC. The closer you are to DC, the more expensive your house is, and the faster it goes. Some houses sell right away the same day it's listed. There isn't much of a deliberation process, and it has to be the right house for the right price in the right area. So there's so many factors, and we've to spend our Fridays touring houses. We spent Valentine's Day doing that too. It's very stressful. There's a lot of paperwork involved, a lot of back and forth, a lot of emails. After renting for about 5 years, I really want to settle. I mean, I'm such an earth sign. I really want to put my roots down somewhere. I mean, I have kids already. I really know where I need to be and where I want to be for the next few years. But it's not always going to happen in the timeline I want it to. It's probably the largest thing going on in our family right now. And I am excited for the fact that, you know, even if we're renting or buying or owning, whatever the heck, we get a new space. It'll be refreshing and nice, and I can't wait to, you know, like move my studio a little bit and, you know, just get that jump of enthusiasm again. And, you know, of course the headaches that come with, you know, moving and home decor and all that crap. Should we give them a debt update, you know? Debt-free 2019 went as well as it could. I think I mentioned in my update that I don't think we're gonna finish by the end of the year, which we did not. We talked about it, I think, around November. We roughly had about 30,000 left. The last month or so of the year, December, got really complicated. A lot of incoming checks or payments towards me were very late. So though I made all my payments on time, I'm lucky and very blessed to be able to do that, it didn't like allow us to pay off an obscene amount in the last 2 months. By the end of January, we were credit card debt free, which was an amazing feeling. And I've talked about this on Instagram already, so I won't like get too detailed, and I'll link off the post. So now I only have my student loans left, which are like high 12,000. I mean, that one, it has such good interest that I said I was knocking that out last. Keeps the median of my length of accounts being open larger. You know, it makes my average longer because that matters in the credit score world. I have like two of my oldest accounts for last, which is my car and my student loans. I want to say it's around like 19,000 to go. Credit score is looking great. Bank accounts aren't doing too bad either. Of course, I wish we finished. Anyone who's going through it too, major props to you, and hang on, because it's a huge roller coaster emotion wise. I definitely feel like I failed in some sort of way, even though I knew that it wasn't gonna be done by, you know, New Year's Eve. I went through a moment where I definitely got very like anxious and panicky, because it was like, oh man, like I just really wish I could have, you know, but I did the best I could. And I've done a whole video on, you know, like methods and my tips and what I kept in mind. So if you wanna go check that out, you can. It's weird, because when you're in such a better place than before, it's weird to feel the same way that you did, like with all the, sorry, you know, all the other things that used to be like weights on your shoulders. It doesn't feel much lighter for some reason, but I think it's because I'm so focused on a finish line. I am happy with where my channel's at right now. I'm happy that you guys are enjoying the content I've been putting out. I hope you guys enjoy this one just as much. The kids are gonna be with us for the next few weeks because their dad is in Japan right now, and I will have them for an extended period of time. So I'm gonna definitely be on mom mode. There's like spirit week to handle for them, and homework projects, and then like long-term, like 3 months ago projects are coming to an end. And I know a few people are gonna ask if I'm gonna do any sort of content revolving maybe like house touring, house buying, how that process goes. If we do like fully go towards the route of buying and we're committed to it and we place offers and such, which could be within the next week or so, we'll throw together some sort of mini series probably, because I have, you know, taken clips here and there, and I'll document more of the process just for those who may be, you know, going through the same thing. We'll see how that goes. I hope you guys enjoy this little like quick little vlog lifestyle situation. I like doing this once in a while, maybe like I said, seasonally on here, because it makes me feel like a human. It makes me feel like, yes, I get out of my office and away from my backdrop sometimes. It fulfills my soul. And I think it's a nice way to be able to connect with you guys and also keep me, you know, from burning out with my beauty content. I typically do more of this on my second channel, but not everyone watches that, and I totally understand. And not everyone follows my Instagram, but those two outlets get the updates first. I just kind of catch you guys up here. What is this? Lastly, mentally, I think I am low-key a little exhausted from everything going on, but going to my dance class is always like peaceful to me. I try to go once a week, if not like once every week and a half. I mentioned it before, it's called Kazashe, and it is basically like Zumba times 10. You know, it's a high intensity dance fitness class, local in Springfield, Virginia. I've been going for many, many years. I've taken breaks, I've gone back. They also have classes online, so if you're not local, you can watch the class that I'm in. They just have the stage. There's like a DSLR hanging from the stage, and you can watch and participate and go at your own pace. It, depending on how much effort you put in, is how much you sweat. But if you really like, you hop in on your feet, you know, compared to just like, hey. But it's great for like that endurance and stuff as well. And I have always loved to dance. A lot of people who've been here a long time remember I've mentioned I used to dance in high school. So it's very like just peaceful. If you're local, I would say give it a try. It's like a judgment-free zone. Everyone's welcome, and no one's really staring at you. No one cares if you mess up. And it's also a really nice mental check. You know, you're just like, I'm enjoying my time. I'm sweating all of that negativity out. I'm feeling great, and I'm gonna feel fulfilled by the end of it. So I really like it. Kazashe was nice enough to give me clearance to film. I even dragged Chris, and he can do it, you can do it. He's not much of a dancer. But to be honest, guys, since this is 2020, it's the first time we've chatted in a few months, I have been trying to just shift my mental, because I feel like if I do that, everything else will just, you know, it's gonna fall in place with the correct effort and preparation. So I'm usually very naturally pessimistic. I've become more optimistic throughout the years. Stay a little bit more zen. Janae Aiko, who's like one of my favorites. Like if you haven't listened to her, like come on. Manifestation, affirmations, all that good stuff. Meditation in the mornings when I'm walking the dog. It's all been really helping. It's really lifting weight and it makes it easier on bad days and it makes me more productive on good days. So that's just me right now mentally, like a good step in the right direction. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Thank you guys so, so much. Don't forget to check out Green Chef. Their link will be at the top of the description box and support the channel. And trust me, this is bomb. That is all for me today. I will put my recent uploads on the screen. Hopefully these workout clips don't get me demonetized. That is all for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching, supporting. Make sure you leave like a heart emoji down below or drop a comment and I will see you guys in a later video. I don't want your life. Why are you over there puffing and puffing?
This is the view from cooking. Isn't it the cutest little view? Hello, look at your little foot. Look at your hands. She's like, just make the food.